Krishna. Say louder, Hare Krishna. I think you have not taken prasad. Louder, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare. Hare Rama. Hare Rama. Rama Rama. Hare Hare. जगन्नाथ बलदेव सूत्र में की जगन्नाथ बलदेव सूत्र में रथ यात्रा महामहोत्सव की शुड आई टेल अ स्टोरी सो दिस स्टोरी हैपेंड हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू वांट द मर्सी ऑफ कृष्णा कृष्णा इज रियल कृष्णास मर्सी इज रियल दिस स्टोरी हैपेंड एग्जैक्टली 500 years ago, and this is there in history books. There was a king by name Raja Purushottam Dev. We need silence. 1, 2, 3. So, Raja Purushottam Dev. Attained the age of marriage. He was ready for the marriage. He was a king for Puri, where Jagannath always lives in Puri. Down south, Tamil Nadu, there was a king ruling Kanchi. He had a daughter by name Padmavati. Everybody is listening?
Yes!
Louder. So, her name was Padmavati. The king of Kanchi came to know there is a good king ready for marriage. So they went and approached him and the marriage was arranged. So the marriage was arranged and the agreement, what do you call, engagement was made. Engagement was over. Then Purushottam Dev said to the minister, don't go home. In 2 days, we have Rath Yatra. Come and attend Rath Yatra. So what happened? So Rath Yatra started. How many of you took part in today's Rath Yatra? So king being the head of the kingdom, he took a golden broom. He started sweeping the road for Lord Jagannath. So immediately minister saw this. What is this? We are giving our daughter to a sweeper? He is sweeping the roads? How can we give our daughter to a sweeper? So he went back to his kingdom and said, King, this guy is a sweeper. He is sweeping the roads. So then they sent a message. We are cancelling the marriage. Why? We don't want to give our daughter to a sweeper who sweeps on the roads. Raja Purushottam Dev became angry. Jagannath, Krishna is the Lord of the universe. Jagannath, I am his sweeper. What is bad in it? He became so angry. He declared war. What he declared? Louder. So he declared war from all the way from Puri. He walked down south and he attacked the king of Kanchi's fort. You know what happened? Did he win? How many of you think he won? Raise your hands. How many of you think he lost? Raise your hands. You're right, he lost. He lost. All his soldiers were killed and he was also on the verge of death, but he jumped on his horse. He escaped. He came all the way, went to the temple, went in front of Jagannath and said, my Lord, what is this? I went to defend you, your name, and I was defeated. Should I continue?
Yes, yes.
Jagannath Swami spoke. Many people think he is a stone or a wood. He spoke, you know why you are lost? No, Lord, you did not take my blessings before you left. Because you did not take my blessings, you are lost. You declare war again, you will win. Really? But I don't have any soldiers. Jagannath Swami said, no problem. You declare war, you will win. All right, he made an announcement in the kingdom. I have lost because I have not taken the blessings of Lord Jagannath. So Supreme Lord is telling, declare war again. This time we'll become victorious. However, the commander-in-chief, the commander of the army will be Jagannath. Those who want to take part in this army, please join. Because he doesn't have any army. He did not have any army. So who joined the army? 70-year-old, 80-year-old, small children. He was thinking, these guys cannot even walk 5 kilometers. How can I win the war? So one day, they started walking. They have to walk at least 200 miles to fight. He was thinking, how can I fight? These guys, small, 70-year-old, 80-year-old, ladies, small children. They walked 1 mile. Should I continue?
Yeah!
They walked 1 mile and it was so hot like this. One lady was selling buttermilk. How many of you know buttermilk? It was so hot, he said, give all this army buttermilk. So she gave the glass of buttermilk to everyone. And when he came to pay the money, she said, all these guys plus two. What is that? Plus two. Purushottam said, what do you mean plus two? Just before you came for buttermilk, two guys came on the horses. One guy is black. He is on a black horse. One guy is white. He is on a white horse. And they said, we are thirsty. Give us buttermilk. And then I told them, I gave them buttermilk and asked for money. They said, we don't have any money. I demanded for money. They said, we are the commanders in chief for Raja Purushottam Dev. He'll pay you. Then I said, no, give me some proof. That black guy, he took his ring and gave me the ring. You show this ring, king will pay you. And what she did, she gave the ring. The moment he saw the ring, he understood. Whose ring it is? Yes, louder.
Jagannath.
It is Jagannath ring. Wow. The Supreme Lord is already in the front leading the army as a commander in chief. I have no problem. Before the king reached Kanchi, Jagannath and with his brother Baldev went and killed everybody who raised the sword. Without raising the sword, Raja Purushottam Dev became victorious. Jagannath Swami ki. So what he did, in order to take revenge, he went into the palace and this daughter, Padmavati, the king's daughter, you know, he abducted her and told the minister, her father belittled Jagannath and me, saying, we cannot give our daughter to a sweeper. In order to belittle him, in our kingdom, find a sweeper and get her married. I don't want to even look at her. Get her married to a sweeper. Fine. And he forgot, 1 year over. Again, Rath Yatra came. Because he's a very ardent devotee of Jagannath, he picked up a golden broom, started sweeping the roads. He swept the road, and the Rath Yatra was over. Minister came to him. I have a request for you. What? Past 1 year, I am searching for a good sweeper. My dear king, where can I find a better sweeper than you? You are the sweeper to the king, Jagannath himself. So please marry her. He said, all right, I'll marry her. So Raja Purushottam Dev is a pure devotee of Jagannath. Padmavati is a pure devotee of Jagannath. Who was born? Maharaj Pratapudra. Whose books is there? Whose name is there in the history books of India? How many of you know Pratapudra? He was born because of the mercy of Jagannath Swami. జగన్నాథ స్వామికి
జై.
థాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్. హరే కృష్ణ.
Thank you for that fantastic history. History. What a great storyteller, eh? Awesome. So now we have somebody. It's interesting. We're talking about Jagannath Puri. We have a guest here. She's a professional dancer. My favorite kind of Indian dance, Odissi. She's come all the way from Bhubaneswar. Yeah. She's a professional dancer. Her name is Srimati Sonali Mishra. She is the disciple of Srimati Sujata Mohapatra. And she will be presenting two items in the Odissi style, which is the classical dance from Orissa, India. It's my favorite. I love it. It's fantastic. The first item, Megh Pallavi, is a short nritta, pure dance piece, based on the rag of Megh and the tal of Jhampa, or 10 beats. Choreography was by Guru Sri Ratikant Mohapatra. Music composition by Pradeep Kumar Dash. I want you to put your hands together, give a great welcome all the way from India, Srimati Sonali Mishra. come on, put your hands together. There was in watching the graceful movements of Srimati Sonali Mishra, disciple of Srimati Sujata Mahapatra. She's all the way from Bhubaneswar,